Hi everybody, I'm actually going to practice what I'm going to do in class tomorrow, and I thought I would record it in case I come up with anything good. This is going to be a review of inheritance. When I say review, I'm going to do some examples while I narrate, which I think will help many of you maybe clarify some things about inheritance. So I'm going to call this project Inheritance. Improv, and I'm going to create a separate project for it, and I'm going to now add a class, and let's make the class called Animal, which would be the top level parent class, because we're going to create subclasses relating to animals. Okay, it's not going to be a static class, so I'm going to begin with creating animal. And we're going to say about an animal, that we can always ask for whether or not the animal is a mammal. So I'm going to say is mammal. It has no parameters. Is that how you spell mammal? Does it have two M's? I'm not sure. And since the first one is going to be an unknown kind of animal, we're going to return false by default. And that's our animal. And we have to test this program, so I'm going to create a main program. And I'm going to call this Inheritance Improv. There, I'm going to spell it wrong again. That doesn't matter too much. Inheritance Improv. And we're going to give it a public static main. And here we go. And I'm going to simply start by saying animal first equals new animal. And of course, it does not know what an animal is, so we're going to and I'm going to say if first is mammal, then system.out.println that's a mammal. And if I run this program now, of course we know that we can't say for sure that it's a mammal, so if I run it, it doesn't print anything out. So if I make it a little bit fancier and I say else system.out.println not mammal, not sure yet whether mammal has one L. It's got to have two M's. You know, when you repeat it often enough, it starts making no sense anymore. And if I run this now, you notice, by the way, that the if then else does not have curlies because there's only one line in each one. I run it now. It's not a mammal, as we would have thought. Okay, great. Let's go create something that we know for sure is a mammal. I'm going to create a new class. New class, and I'm going to call it cow. And I'm going to leave it like this. Notice that it says superclass is just object. And I'm going to now say public boolean is mammal. Maybe there's two M's after all. true. Sorry, that's not what I meant. Return true. And we're very good. I'm going to go back and change all my mammals to two M's because now I saw it by itself and I saw the error of my ways. Mammal with two M's. And now we are going to do the same thing again. We're going to have a new line that's going to say cow second equals new copy this code. Click it here. Oops, nope. Paste it here. And say about second. Second is mammal. And we have some errors here. And it is that, oh my god. Get rid of that. And little known fact, maybe that will amuse you, I can go to source and format it, and it makes it pretty. Isn't that nice? So it's not a mammal. Mammal, run it again. Fit my M's everywhere. There we go. We run it again, and instead of saying that, I'm going to say first is a mammal. First is not a mammal. Second is a mammal. Second is not a mammal. Okay, all good. I'm going to run it. And I'm going to say first is not a mammal and second is a mammal. That's great. But how redundant is that? Okay, let's give these animals names. So I'm going to go to animal again. And I'm going to say, in addition to that, when we construct it, and I'm going to say name, this.name equals name. And of course, that's not going to work because I haven't declared the field name. So I'm going to put here private string name. And I'm going to have one more line here, which is going to be public string get name. And it's going to return name. And we're good. And I'm going to take similar code. I'm going to go to cow and add the same thing. Of course, this has to say cow now. And we have to add the string name, make it public. Great. And now we have to fix this because when I create a new animal, I'm going to say I'm a, fish. Fish called Wanda. And I'm going to be a cow called Moo. And now I can improve this a little bit. I can say, instead of saying that, I'm going to say first.getName plus is a mammal. It's a mammal. And I can make something pretty similar here. I could say second.getName is a mammal. And I can say here first.getName plus not a mammal. Oops, make it a call. And second.getName plus, plus not a mammal. Now I run it and I get fish called Wanda is not a mammal. Cow called Moo is a mammal. That's pretty cool, isn't it? Boy, that's pretty redundant, though. So that makes me think, this code for animal and the code for cow, boy, they look the same. I'm going to now add one more animal to this. I'm going to add a shark. Oh, a shark is hard. Let's call it a flounder. Class flounder. I say that because I'm not totally sure a shark is an animal, it is a fish, it may be something else. So instead of getting into that, get into an argument with biologists in the class, I thought I would just call it a flounder. And we're going to, once again, I'm not going to do that nonsense again. What I'm going to do instead is I'm going to say extends creature. And leave it at that for now. Now I see here, what is a creature? I'm going to create the class creature, and I'm going to give it all the characteristics that we need to have. So we're going to start by creating a class called creature and finish. And the creature is going to have the general public void, sorry, public boolean getName. I'm back. GetName, and I'm going to return. Oh, sorry, not GetName. Oops, sorry. Is mammal. I'm going to return false because we don't know for sure it's a mammal. Then we're going to just say it's not public. GetName and public string. Sorry, string. GetName, and I'm going to return not if you are seeing this message, then there is a bug. Why? Because really I don't want anybody ever to be working with creatures. I want to use the subclass of creature because the creature is undefined. So now we're going to go to Flounder and take advantage of this new functionality. And I'm going to override I don't have to override the is mammal because we know that the creature is already said to be not a mammal, but I think for completeness, I do want to do that. So I'm going to say public boolean is mammal, and I'm going to return false, and that's all I have to do here. I can go back to creature and realize that getName is getName is going to require a string, so private string name. That way everybody, every creature has a name. And I was mistaken here. What I really wanted to do is modify the constructor for creature. So I'm going to say creature and all I do in creature is I assign a value to name equals, if you are seeing this and that. Bug, and I'm going to have getName just return this name. Okay. Now what's going on here is what I've done is I've said getName will always return the name. Anything that's a creature has a name. Anything that's a creature is by default not a mammal. And then I go to Flounder. And I say Flounder is also not a mammal, and that's just a safety guard. But I have to do something else. I have to create a constructor with a parameter, right? So I'm going to create creature string name. And I'm sorry, Flounder. Incorrect. Flounder name. And I'm going to say this.name equals name. Now, because Flounder extends creature, and creature has a field called name, I don't have to define it. It's coming out of the fact that this is also a creature, but I do have a little error. It's telling me that the creature, which is defining the name, is making it private. And because the parent class field is private, it's not accessible by anybody, even a subclass. Interesting. So if you look at the choices, I have two choices. I can make the field and creature, the name field and creature be public, but that kind of defeats my purpose. Or I can use a new one, which we haven't really talked about in class, called protected, which is a field that is available to only subclasses, to nobody else. And that fixes the problem over here. Okay, great. Let's continue, and now let's modify our main program. I'm going to comment all this out for the moment. I'll come back to it. And I'm going to instead, I don't want to comment this one out. Instead, I'm going to add a flounder. Oops. Flounder f equals new flounder. Bottom feeder. I think they are. I'm not sure actually. And that's good, right? And now I'm going to write if f dot is mammal, then print dot out dot print line f dot get name. Okay, and is a mammal, else okay, I'm gonna run this and let's see what happens. Bottom feeder is a mammal. What? That's not right. What I should have said is, why is bottom feeder a mammal? Well, let's go look. I'm calling is mammal in flounder. Bottom feeder is its name, yes. F is mammal, it's returning true. If we go to bottom feeder, to flounder, we see that flounder has a method called is mammal that returns false. And creature, in turn, has a method called isMammal that also returns false. And yet, here, f isMammal is returning true, which is a mystery, isn't it? So I am indeed sincerely mystified, but that doesn't scare me. I'm going to put a breakpoint in here. And maybe you already saw my bug. And I'm going to, oops. Says that, yes, I won't allow that. That's fine, that doesn't matter. And I have the first call f. F is bottom feeder. F is class. Is flounder. And we're going to call the f is mammal. Ha. Does everybody see my mistake now? I see it. Oh, indeed, it does correctly return false for its mammal, but I did modify the text of the print. Okay, can happen in the best of families, no problem. So we're going to stop this debug. We're going to return back to the regular display, and I'm going to put in not. And now when I run it, we are in good shape. It's not a mammal. Excellent. Now, let us continue. Let us now see if we can convert animal. Let's convert cow. All right, so we see everything's good. Now I'm going to try to convert cow to this new model. So I'm going to say cow extends creature as well. Extends creature. And guess what? We can get rid of this. Is mammals have to return true? We can get rid of this constructor, and we can get rid of getName. So really, the only difference between a cow and the general creature is that it is a mammal. That seems pretty cool. So let's go see if that's true. So let's think about this for a second. So what I'm saying is, creature is the parent class of cow, which means that creature is supplying both the default field, the fields, and the methods to the subclass. So let's go look at creature. Creature defines a field called name. It defines a constructor. A constructor without parameters, by the way, note. It defines a method called isMammal, which always returns false. And it defines a method called getName, which returns whatever name is. So these are present in creature. Anybody who subclasses creature, who extends creature, will get these. for free. So flounder extends creature, and all it really needs to do is to provide the as mammal. Now, hey, why is it necessary for me to provide a constructor for flounder? After all, creature has a constructor as well. Oh, but wait, no, it doesn't have a constructor which takes no parameters. It has a constructor that takes eight parameters. So if I went to flounder and I removed this constructor, I would have a problem. This is fine, but I would go back. Now, look closely now. Now, because flounder does not have a constructor of its own, all it has is the constructor supplied by creature. Creature's constructor is a no-parameter constructor. Does not take a parameter. So we're going to have an error right here. It's going to tell me that new flounder bottom feeder is invalid because there is no constructor for flounder, which takes no parameters because I just deleted it, right? So we can just improve creature now to actually take a parameter. And now we can do what we did before, this.name equals name. And now every class that is a subclass of creature that extends creature is going to inherit this particular constructor. So we look here, we have an error. Now what is the error? Let's check this out. The error is as follows. Implicit superconstructor creature is undefined for the default constructor. What does that mean? What it means is this. When no constructor is supplied in a class, it is expected that there is a constructor that takes no parameters. However, there is here no constructor that takes no parameters. There is also within creature no constructor that takes no parameters because there's only one, and it's this one, the one that takes one parameter. So I can solve this in two ways. The way I'm going to solve it is I'm going to actually take this error's advice and add a constructor here, which simply does the following. Look closely. It is a constructor on flounder that takes one parameter, that's the name. What does it do with it? It invokes the constructor of its parent class. Parent class is creature. It invokes the constructor of creature. You can do the same thing to cow. We're just using Eclipse's help, but it's going to do exactly the same thing. And now we're all set. Now we have both cow and flounder working with very little code. Now, what happened to animal? Well, we put animal in originally to be a generic animal. It really had no characteristics, so it doesn't have a purpose anymore. So we're not going to use it anymore. But let's think about it. Now, what if we wanted to have a method called lives underwater? Where would we put that method? Well, there's a couple of choices. We could put that method, but let's first go to inheritance improv and look at this program that we have so far. So we now have flounder bottom feeder, and we have cow c equals new, because we updated cow as well, which was going to be new cow. And that's fine. And we can write the same code here. And now you know what happens. I'm going to execute this code. I'm going to take this, make this C. I'm going to execute this code. It's going to work just fine. But I'm starting to get annoyed because I am repeating myself. This code is no longer dry. It's true that it's working. Moo cow is a mammal, bottom feeder is not a mammal, but this code is not dry. So let's dry it up. How do we dry it up? The way we dry it up is we're going to add a method called public static void print info. And what is the info? Let's continue first. And we're just going to take this code here, and we're going to mimic it. We're going to take this out, because it's the same. 18 through 21, 22, and 25 through 28 are almost the same, right? I'm going to take this out, and I'm going to put it here. Okay, but wait a minute. Now we have C. We're trying to print out whether this some arbitrary object is, in fact, a mammal or not, and what its name is. And so this code that we had is line 24, said check that about cow C. The same code we had line 18 asked that about cow, about flounder F. So we need something generic. Ah, so what are we going to put in here is something generic. Do we put in here flounder F, cow C? Well, we could. Once I do that, I can take this code out, and I can just simply say print info of C. And that works great, because print info of C on line 25 is calling line 28. However, if I try to do the same thing over here, print info of F, I will have an error. What is my error? My error is that print info expects a cow as its parameter, but here I'm giving it a flounder. That's not going to work. However, notice that both cow and flounder are kinds of creatures. So if I say print info runs against creatures, now both of these work. Why? Because F and C, F is a flounder, C is a cow. However, they're both subclasses of creature. Now I have this one code here. I run it, does the same thing, but I have less code. Isn't that amazing? Now let's say whether we want, bring one more thing in here. Let's say we would like to check whether C can swim. Swim is not the right word. Survive underwater, because a cow probably can swim under the right circumstances. So if I say if C dot can swim, I can say furthermore, put the space back, put the back in, I'm going to say system.println c.getName can also swim. Fine. But system.out, we have to write this can swim method, can't, don't we? So we're going to put it in a flounder, we're going to put another method called can swim. Public boolean can swim. And we return true. That should fix it, shouldn't it? Let's go look. No, because creature C, we look at C, we look at creature, does it have a can swim? No. Okay, well let's add it then to let's add the same thing to a cow, but this time returning false. Now both cow and flounder have a can swim method. Will this fix the problem? No. Why? Because C is a creature. It's neither a cow nor a flounder nor a crocodile. It's a creature. And we don't know anything about creatures, whether they can swim or not. All we know is about cows and flounders. So what we really need to do is we have to go to creature and add, analogous to is mammal, we're going to add public boolean can swim, and we're going to return false. Now this should work. Now the error message has gone away, and if I run it, it's going to say bottom feeder is not a mammal. Bottom feeder can also swim. Moo cow is a mammal. Excellent. Is there a way to improve this further? Well, maybe. I think it's pretty good the way it is. Let's get rid of this code because it just confuses me now. I don't like all this green code. It's looking pretty nice. Let's see. What else can we do that's interesting? Well, what if we wanted to have a new kind of creature that can fly. So let's add a bird. Let's add a generic bird, shall we? So we're going to create a new class, file new class. And we're going to call it the bird, and we're going to make it inherit from creature. And go. There it is, public class bird. Now it's complaining because there is no, remember, we are assuming the constructor receives the name of the creature, right? So we're going to add a public, no, just creature, string name, nope, again, bird, string name, and all we have to do is super name, and we're done. Now, if we add to our inheritance demo now one more thing, we're going to add bird b equals new bird Tweety and print info about b. And run it. We'll see. Tweety is not an animal. Bottom feeder. Okay, everything's good. In fact, I'm going to add to make this a little bit more legible. I'm going to put here quote backslash n plus. Now, it's going to look a little bit more legible. Bottom feeder is not an animal, not a mammal, but it can swim. Oh, not. Now I'm getting confused, right? How to keep track of what's what? Well, what if we wanted to be able to keep track of what the English word is for this particular category of living being? Because I would like to be able to say, instead of just the name of the particular bird, called Tweety, I would like to remember that it's part of the bird group, right? The bird family. So I'm going to add here c.get, species, and plus a quote, plus a quote, plus, do the same thing here. Copy this text over here. Okay, that's good, except get species is not defined. That's fine, we're going to fix it. We're going to go right into creature, and we're going to add a public string, capitalized string, get species, and it's going to return unknown species. This means there is a bug. I'm going to run it. Oh my god. Okay, that's not good. Everybody's an unknown. Why is that? Well, because they're all calling creatures get species. I'm going to have to define it for each one. So I'm going to go to bottom feeder, or flounder, and I'm just going to add its own version, public string get species, under capitalized string get species, and I'm going to return flounder. And I'm going to add one to cow. And I'm going to add one to bird. Now when I run this, flounder bottom feeder is not a mammal. Bottom feeder can also swim. Cow moo cow is a mammal. Bird tweety is not a mammal. And of course the only one who can swim is bottom feeder. I don't like the appearance of this, so I'm going to teach you one more nice idea. I'm going to rewrite this whole print statement as follows. System dot out dot print f. I'm going to, a format string tells a certain template for a string. So I'm going to write the template like this. this. I'm going to put backslash n, start a new line, percent s, which is going to be the species, percent s, which is going to be the name, and I'm going to put is percent s a mammal, and is percent s able to swim, quote. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4 strings, right? So the first string is going to be the name. So it's going to be C dot, no, it's going to be the species, get species. The second one is going to be the name, C dot get name. The third parameter, percent s is, yeah, okay, good, is a mammal and is able to swim. Now I have to say, I have to make two strings. I'm going to just start by saying is not and is not. That's good. So if I run this program, I'm going to be partially there. That's the string that was made by this line 16. And of course, it says not every time. That's not very useful. So what do I do next? String mammalness is, let's do it this way. Better than that. Let's say string mammalness and string swimness. Swimmable. Okay. And now I'm going to write, take this code here, I'm showing you this just to broaden your horizons, okay? Is mammal, I'm going to say, do you know what I'm going to say here? I'm going to say mammalness, oops, that's a mistake, mammalness equals is just nothing, else mammal. Mammalness is not. And? Oh, I didn't mean to do that, but okay. Now I really messed you up, didn't I? Okay. And I can get rid of this. And I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to say if c.canSwim, then swimmable is nothing, else swimmable is not. Not. Okay, good. Now, last thing I have to do is get rid of these lines. This is nice and shrunk, isn't it? And I'm going to put here, let's reformat this. This is going to be mammalness. Mammalness, and this is going to be swimmable. Again. Shrink this more by getting rid of these curly brackets. I can ask Eclipse to format it for me. Lovely. And now when I run it, there's a mistake here somewhere. Let's see what the error is, if any. It seems like it gave me an error. Let's try that again. Flounder bottom feeder is not a mammal and is able to swim. Cool cow, moo cow is a mammal and is not able to swim. Bird tweedy is not a mammal and is not able to swim. Good. Oh, but now since I have one string, it's very nice. I can now say, add a quote, add another quote. The backslash is so that this quote does not terminate this string. It's called an escape, and it just says, use the quote as it is. So if I hit now, even better. Okay, now let's go back to our is able to swim, and what about being able to go back to bird, and we saw here that bird we want to be able to say is able to fly, right? So go to creature, and get name, can swim, is mammal. Let's add one more, which is public string, public boolean can fly, and we're going to return false by default. And now we can add to bird, we can add public boolean can fly, return true. But notice I do not have to add it to flounder and cow because they inherit the can fly method from creature. So I can modify my top level program now to add one more construct just like these, which is going to be if c.canFly, then flyable is empty string, else flyable is not. I'm going to add a string called flyable, and that's my print info. There's still an error because I don't have a semicolon here. Is able to swim and percent s, which could be a not if this was necessary, able to fly. And of course, then I have to add flyable here. It's getting more and more easy by having this inheritance. Can you see how? And instantly now we can say they're able to fly, not able to fly, so a bird can fly, everybody else cannot fly. Isn't that cool? So you can just imagine, we can just go on like this. But I think I'll stop here. And I don't know how long this video is or whether I'm even going to publish it, because this looks like a good one to use tomorrow in class as I'm talking about this. So thank you for putting up with this, and see you tomorrow.